and we choose three kind of the curry paste. The first one is red curry paste, and green curry paste, and the masaman curry paste, which is the curry paste that we use in our actual diet. This is the ingredient in the red curry paste. It's composed of 7 spice herbs. And the yellow color is the item that is common among 3 of the curry paste. And this one is the ingredient in the green curry paste, which use the fresh green chili, and is composed of 9 spice herbs. And the last one is contain 11 spice and herb in masaman. So it have the common of the spice in among these 3 curry paste, which is chilies, garlic, fresh lemongrass, fresh olive, and dried capsicum peel. This is the outcome of the effect of red curry paste on the inflammation biomarkers productions. The condition of the cells experiment is the same as that I explained in the individual spice. And you can see that the mixed spice in the red curry paste show the potential to reduce the inflammation biomarker production in the dose dependent in both marker 1 and marker 2 as well. And the results showing the same in the green curry paste and the masaman curry paste as well. So it means that when the spice mix together in the mixture, the bioactive compound in the mixed spice still showing the high potential to reduce the inflammatory process, which is like it's occur in our habitual diet, that we eat the mixture, we didn't eat the individual. So the next one, I will demonstrate the activity in the ready-to-eat Thai popular dish cooked with the curry paste. The first one is stir-fried chicken with red curry, or in Thai, pad phikkankai, and the other one is the chicken red curry with coconut milk or pankai. These two dishes will be conducted our experiment is already ready to eat, and then we just extract this compound from these two popular dishes. And this is the ingredient of the stir-fried chicken with red curry. It's composed of 6. The yellow one is the common between 2 popular dishes. It's composed of red curry paste, and chicken, and bristled pea eggplant, sweet basil, and green peppercorn. This one is the ingredient in pankai. It's have the red curry, chicken, pea eggplant, red chili, kaffirun leaf, and the sweet basil. And this is the result, the outcome that show you that the ready-to-eat of the stir-fried chicken with curry, red curry, showing the same result that happened in the individual and in the mixed spice. Also in kankai, the chicken red curry with coconut milk. So it means that 2 kind of our Thai popular dish containing curry paste showing high anti-inflammation activity. However, the result that I show you is the cell culture model, which is the in vitro. The in vitro have several points of advantage, but also have the limitation as well. The first one that is have the advantage that cell culture can be used to identify the targets of the disease process. It's quick and simple, and many items can be done in a short time. It's suitable for using as an initial screening the biological function of the numerous food items in the habitual diets. Because we have, I think, more than 100 of the plant, and we cannot do all of the 100 in the in vivo. So we use this model for like a screening. However, the cell culture also has some limitations. The important point is it's not reflect the whole body physiological conditions. And the significant on human health of these in vitro data obtained from cell culture has to be carefully re-evaluated in vivo or in animal or in human. So the future research that we're planning to do, yeah, we would like to investigate this functional property in animals or human to clarify the impact of the spice and herbs rich foods intake or the specific disease biomarkers. And this study is sponsored by, for example, the individual spite is sponsored by the International Nutrition Foundation, Edison Medical Foundations, and also I would like to deeply thank Dr. Mark Feller in Ohio State University. And the Thai curry paste was supported by Mahidol University. And I would like to thank all of the people who supported me to conduct this informative experiment. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you so much, Siripon. For next, I would like to introduce Assistant Professor Dr. Sanipan by three. Bunji, sorry. She would like to have a topics of chemo preventive effects of some Thai herbs and vegetables. She got PhD from my university on the 2008.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to thank the organizing committee to give me a chance to present my work today. My talk today is the chemo preventive effects of some Thai herbs and vegetables. This is the scope of my presentation. I would like to give you some information about the definition of chemo prevention and follow to the mechanism of chemoprevention in carcinogenesis and chemopreventive phytochemicals and dietary resources. And lastly, I will inform you about the chemoprevention study of some Thai herbs and vegetables that are studied in National Cancer Institute Thailand in collaboration with the Institute of Nutrition at the University in animal models. That means we move from the in vitro model to the in vivo, that the animal model is close to the human. And I will inform you about the short-term assays, medium-term bioassays, long-term animal carcinogenicity study. Talking about the diets and cancer, many dietary constituents can increase the risk of developing cancer, but there is also accumulating evidence from population as well as laboratory study to support an inverse relationship between liquid consumption of fruits and vegetables and the risk of specific cancer. Many organizations such as WHO, American Cancer Society, American Institute for Cancer Research, and National Cancer Institute in US has established a dietary guideline to help people reduce the cancer risk. For the definition of the chemo prevention, the chemo prevention is the use of agent to inhibit, reverse, or retard tumorigenesis. Tumorigenesis is undergo to the carcinogenesis process, and the cancer can occur. The numerous phytochemicals derived from edible plants have been reported to interfere with a specific stage of the carcinogenic process. It is interesting to be noted that many phytochemicals are present in our daily diets. Let me give you some background again about the multi-stage of carcinogenesis. This is the step of carcinogenesis. Carcinogenesis is initiated with the transformation of the normal cells into the cancer cell we call is initiated cells. These cells undergo tumor promotion into the pre-neoplastic cell, which progression step become to the neoplastic cell. The phytochemicals can interfere with different steps of this process. They can interfere in the step of the procarcinogen undergo to the initiated cells, or it can suppress the promotion and the progression process. And this is a mechanism of the chemo prevention. The H3 phytochemical can block or suppress the multi-stage carcinogenesis. Some chemo preventive phytochemical work as a blocking agent, such as the allergic acid. This is an active compound that contain in the many type of berry, such as strawberry, cranberry, and raspberry. And indole-carminol, this active compound in the cabbage, and the sulforaphane in us, some kinds of cruciferous, and flavonoids is contained in various kinds of fruit and vegetable. This can inhibit the metabolic activation of the procarcinogen to their ultimate electrophilic species of their subsequent interact with the DNA. This agent therefore block the tumor initiation. We call them as a blocking agent. And alternatively, the H3 blocking agent can stimulate the detoxification process of a carcinogenesis, leading to their secretion from the body. And the other phytochemical suppress the later stage of the carcinogenesis. We call them as a suppressing agent. The suppressing agent such as the beta carotene that contained in dark leafy vegetable or the carrot, and curcumin is an active phytochemical in turmeric, and EGCD is an active compound in green tea, and genistein in soybean, and resveratrol in grape, and gingerol is an active compound in ginger. And the last one is the capsaicin, is an active compound in chili. Some phytochemical can act as a both blocking agent or suppressing agent. This is a chemo preventive phytochemical and added resources. Vegetable and fruit are excellent sort of cancer preventive substance. The National Cancer Institute identified 35 plant-based food that pose cancer preventive property. This is an example. This is an example of a plant-based food that pose a cancer preventive property. The first one is the turmeric. Chili pepper, ginger, green tea, soybean, tomatoes, grapes, honey, garlic, and cruciferous group such as cabbage and broccoli. The active compound that showed chemo preventive effect has identified flock of each kind or each type of plants. The numerous cell culture and animal model study have been conducted to evaluate the ability of specific edible plants to prevent cancer. Let me give you some example about the active phytochemical in chili. Professor Yang Jun Sir from Seoul National University in Korea revealed about the capsaicin. Capsaicin is an active compound in chili, has the ability to induce apoptosis, preferential in the cancerous of transformed cell. This is a new trend to study about the role or the benefit of the phytochemical underlying the molecular mechanism. He found that capsaicin in hot chili peppers makes tumor cells commit suicide. Another example is a substance in grapes called as the resveratrol. Back to the 1997, the researcher team from the University of Illinois conduct the study about the resveratrol, and they found that the resveratrol efficiently suppressed each stage of multi-step of carcinogenesis. And after the pioneer research on the resveratrol, there are many studies about the resveratrol undergoing to the molecular mechanism. So now, I would like to mention just only about the chemo prevention study in Thai herbs and vegetable in animal models. The animal models are play an important role in screening appropriate plants for the preventive approach of human cancer. I would like to mention about the three different assays. The first one is a short-term assay. I would like to specify just only in vivo electrocyte micronucleus assay in the mouse has been used for the anticarcinogenicity. The term of the anticarcinogenicity is the inhibit of the chromosome breakage. And the second one is the medium-term bioassay. The researcher from the National Cancer Institute Thailand study about this bioassay by using the Professor Ito model and to confirm about the benefit of the chemo preventive activity of various kind of vegetable. The researcher from the National Cancer Institute conduct the study in the long-term animal carcinogenicity study such as the liver, mammary gland or colon cancer model in rat and mice. This is the detailed information about the three different assays, the short-term, medium-term and long-term. For the long-term, more than 7 months has been conducted in the experiment. The specific animal model has been studied in each assay. The specific carcinogen that induce the specific cancer in the specific organ has given to the animal experiment, and the endpoint marker is different between short-term, medium-term, and long-term. We use to count the number of micronucleus for the short-term assay, and for medium-term, we determine the positive cell foci in rat liver, and histopathological of our organ that interest, such as the liver, mammary, and colon, has been determined for the long-term study. Why do we use the erythrocyte micronucleus assay for short-term assay for the chemo prevention? Because the reliability of the method was validated by the extended collaborative study organized by the collaborative study group for the micronucleus test of the family mutagenesis study group of the Environmental Mutagenesis Society of Japan. This is a big group of the researchers to study about the chemo prevention. So now we use this method to assay or determine the chemo preventive effects of some Thai herbs and vegetables. Let me give you briefly about this method. The peripheral blood micronucleus assay is the study done in an animal model. This method is established by Professor Hayashi in 1990. Firstly, mice were given the vegetable mix in the standard diet, or rather were given the sample in intragastrically daily for 2 weeks before rat or mice were given the carcinogenesis. Two types of carcinogenesis were given to mice, such as a direct acting carcinogen and indirect acting carcinogen. The blood were taken at a specified time, and blood were obtained from tail and placed in acrylic orange coated slide, and the micronucleus that